salmon. Make sure you get a salmon who's got like lovely, bubbly, shiny eyes like that one. Make sure it's very fresh in the gills. Cut just under the head and turn your knife towards the center bone. Cutting through right the backbone of the salmon. Just follow flat with your knife and you will start to feel really the backbones here lifting up the tail of the salmon. When you are up the head, cut straight down the rib cage and open your salmon. And just keep your knife flat and follow down towards the belly skin. So we will remove all the fatty parts we're not going to use. The last thing we need to take is all those big pig bones. We'll do in a minute. Discard of the bones. I'm going through the excess bones on the left side towards the head. Lifting up again, making sure you're right where the flesh is and cut straight through. Now to remove the skin of the salmon fillet, cut a little incision towards the tail without cutting the skins. You can see the skins is there, straight through there, and keep it as a holder. Put your knife towards the skin and make some very slight move, holding and making sure you're picking up all the flesh of your salmon. Making that little move will help you holding the salmon. And you can see the salmon is sticking up the board and helping you at the same time. Now you can lift it up completely and you can see that the skin doesn't contain any flesh. For salmon tartare, what we're gonna do now is to remove the excess of blood and fatty bits on the back of the salmon. Cutting a little diagonal incision on the right and do exactly the same size on the left. Lifting up all the excess in nearly one move. You got two systems where you can remove the pins, bones in the center using a small knife and pitch it up with your fingers and lift it up slightly towards the head. A more easy way to do when you do salmon tartare is to cut just on the side of the bones, making sure you're not breaking them, falling straight down. See, one didn't want to come with me, and cutting exactly on the other side. You do lose a little bit of salmon, but it is a bit easier to do, so it's a choice to be made. Cut your steaks hard and have nice little supreme skinless ready for poaching or roasting. You need to cut the knives, putting this in the same next to each other. And cutting again in very regular small dice. To rinse off your salmon, use a little colander. Put your salmon bits. And just rinse it. Just slightly. Not more than that. I'll use a bit of answering paper to get the excess of waters off. And we've got our salmon for the tartar. If you cut the bottom of your shallots, and the top of your shallots, put in the skins with you. You will end up having filling the first layer. Just picking up the first layers all together. It will stop you hurting the shallots and not crying at all. To dice your shallots after the peel, just do some nice incisions and do the same again, flat down without cutting the bottom of your shallots. You will end up having different little buttons ready to be sliced up. Cutting very finely and very regularly, you end up having what we call an echelot ciselé, or very finely diced shallots. Add your salmon to it, add a good pinch of chopped shallots, fresh dill, making a very small bundle of herbs without over pressing it, so you don't want to bruise the salad. You just want to have an easy way of chopping it very finely. Use your knife very in the same sort of rounded cutting as we did with the shallots. If you bruise your herbs, all the herbs will turn black and the flavor will disappear of what we really need for our recipe. Do your salmon tartare. We've got some beautiful pommery mustard from the town of Lagny where I was born. Add a little spoon of that. Some beautiful clear honey from Vers-sur-Marne. A good one of freshly grounded black pepper. Add a slightly little bit of salt at the start to season. Mix your ingredients and you can see everything starting to bond very nicely together. Adding some beautiful crème fraîche from our lovely country of Normandy in the north of France where all the colors are really beautiful. Adding a spoonful of crème fraîche. And mixing and bonding all ingredients very nicely together. So now you can notice we've got the crème fraîche with a bit sour. And we got the mustard was a bit sharp. And the honey was very sweet. The last thing missing for your salmon is lovely bits of freshly squeezed lemon juice. Get the top of your cucumbers. Get a vegetable peeler. Peel your cucumbers from top. Bottom. Cut your cucumbers long ways. Remove with a teaspoon all the seeds. It will help you very much towards a lovely digestion. Cutting the cucumbers in half. You're going to try to make some nice layers of very thin. For the cucumber tagliatelle, just use a little colander on the cucumber to it. A bit of salt. A little bit of black pepper. A little drizzle of distilled vinegar to give it the sweetness back. And mix it. Mix it well. Now we're gonna a few minutes and you've got the excess water of your cucumbers. Rinse it under the cold tap and you will see it's still nice and crunchy. Make sure you get all that excess water off. Squeeze it just slightly, a little bit, and add it to your seasoning bowls. As the first one is gone now with the water, a little bit of black pepper. Some beautiful organic extra virgin olive oil, just a little drizzle. You'll find that taste of the cucumbers at the last minute and a little dash of that beautiful distilled vinegar. We're gonna add lightly, very roughly chopped dill to it. Build up our beautiful well marinated salmon in a lovely ring mold. You can arrange very nicely all your lovely tagliatelles and dill marinated salad. For my last finish touching, that beautiful cream of Normandy. Sweet. A little malt on the top, and a little bit of organic caviar, just slightly to the top, and using a little bit more of that nice organic dill to the top. Now your salmon should be very nicely set, and make a beautiful salmon tartare à la croque de concombre et de tagliatelle. Bon appétit.